Hey, what's going on guys? My name is Jim Fahad. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this beautiful long portfolio image scrolling using Elementor Page Builder. So you may have long images. Let's say you have created some websites and you may have long screenshot images of those websites. Then by using this technique, you can put your whole long image and people can scroll through over the image like this. In this way, you can showcase all of your long portfolio images within this specific section. And I will show you how to do that using Elementor Page Builder. So without further ado, let's now go inside Elementor Page Builder. To take a new section, let's first click on this plus icon. And here I'm taking this three column structure. Now let's give it a height. So I'm giving the height from here. Let's set it to minimum height and I'm giving it in VH. Also, I'm setting the VH to 100 VH. Now let's go inside this middle column. First, I'm selecting this middle column because I wanna add some space around this column. So let's go under advanced tab and here I'm adding 20 pixel of padding with this column. Now within this column, click on this plus icon. Here I'm dragging an inner section and first I'm deleting one of the inner columns from here. So this inner section has only one column. Then I'm making this inner section's column gap to no gap. Now let's click on this plus icon and here I'm dragging an image widget inside of this inner section. Let's now select the image. I'm selecting this long image. Now click on insert media. You see it's pretty long image and from here image size I'm making it to full. And let's now go under style tab. From here I'm making the width to 100%. By the way, if you wanna take this type of long screenshot image, for example, if we go to this website. Now let's say if you wanna have a full screenshot of this image, then you can use a Google extension or Google Chrome extension. I'm using this extension. It says go full page. So when you will install this extension, you can see this little tiny icon at the top of your browser. Then just click here. You see it's taking the screenshot of this whole web page. So in this way, you can take all the full image screenshot of your website. Now from here, you can click on this download to download the whole image. All right, let's now go back inside Elementor. Now you know how to take this full image screenshot images. All right, let's now select this inner section. So I'm selecting by clicking on the six dots. Then go under the advanced tab of this inner section and open the custom CSS field. By the way, custom CSS is only available on Elementor Pro. I will put my Elementor Pro affiliate link in the description. If you purchase Elementor Pro through my affiliate link, you don't have to pay any extra, but I will get a little credit for that. That will help me to continue this YouTube channel and make more interesting tutorials like this. Alright, now within this custom field, I will be pasting some CSS snippet. To get that CSS snippet or CSS code, just go to jimfahaddigital.com. I will put this page's link in the description. From that page, if we scroll down a bit, here under hiding overflow CSS, just copy this CSS snippet from here, go inside Elementor and paste the CSS code here. Now we can see the whole image is adjusted within the inner section and we can specify the height of the inner section from here. You see, by default, I have set the height to 400 pixel, but if you want, you can change it to, for example, 500 pixel or 600 pixel, but I wanna keep it 400 pixel. All right, now I wanna add some shadow with it. So to do that, go under style tab. From here, open the border and from here, box shadow, click on this pencil icon. Then from here, I'm adding the vertical value to 25, the blur value to 50, and the spread value to negative 15. All right, so now we can see it's scrollable within the inner section like this. Already it's looking perfect, but now here I wanna add my custom color scroll bar on the right side here. Instead of this browser default hover color, I mean the hover scroll bar. So to change the scroll bar color, I will be adding some CSS snippet again. To do it, make sure you have selected the inner section, go under the advanced tab, then open the custom CSS. Now let's go again to jimfahaddigital.com. Then if we scroll down here under the scroll bar color CSS, just copy this CSS snippet from here, go inside Elementor. And then after our existing CSS, I'm hitting some enter. So it will make some space in between the codes. Let's now paste the CSS snippet that we have just copied. And if we now minimize the bar from left, here you can see on the right side, we can see our scroll bar color is now red. Now let's say if you want to change the color to any other color, then from left expand the bar. Okay, first let me explain this code. The first thing here, this is the width. I have set it to 4 pixel. For example, instead of 4, if I make it to 40, you see the width is now 40 pixel, but it's looking super weird. So I'm going back to 4 pixel. And then this is the background color of this whole scroll bar. Let's say instead of this #777, if I set it to green. Now you see the whole color is now green, but instead of green, I'm going back to #777777. And then here is the scroll bar color. By default, I have set it to red. That's why we can see the red color, but you can set here any other color like yellow or any color hex code. So now to match this scroll bar color with the image, I wanna take this green color from the image. And I will be using another Google Chrome extension. It says ColorZilla extension. So from here, let's just click on this extension. Now click on pick color from page. Then I'm selecting this green color. Now click here. So the color is now copied on the clipboard. Now here, instead of yellow, I'm pasting the greenish color. Now here on the right side, we can see the scroll bar color is the green color. All right. Now I just wanna simply duplicate this column. Remember, we will be duplicating the outer column, this column. So let's duplicate it and let's duplicate it one more time. Now I wanna remove the empty column from left side. Also, let's delete the empty column from right. And now I will be changing the images very quickly. So for the first image, let's change it to other image. I'm selecting this image, click on insert media, and for the third image, let's select another image. I'm selecting this one, click on insert media. So here for the left one, let's click on this inner section, go under advanced tab and open the custom CSS. Here instead of this green color, I wanna use this yellowish color for this scroll bar. So you know, I'm again selecting the ColorZilla extension, click on pick color from page. So here I'm selecting this yellow color. So it's been copied on the clipboard. Now instead of this color, let's just paste the color. I'm pressing command V. Now you see the scroll bar color is yellowish here with the first image. Then similarly, go to the third image, select this inner section, go under its advanced tab, open the custom CSS. Then again, select the ColorZilla Chrome extension, click on pick color from page. Then here, I wanna select this orange color. And then go to background, instead of this yellowish color, I'm pasting the orange color here. So now with the third image, we can see on the right, the scroll bar color is the orange color. All right, now let's check how these portfolio images looking on tablet and mobile device. So to check the responsiveness, from left click on the responsive mode. So it's already looking great on the desktop device. Let's now go to the tablet device. It's looking great on tablet device also. It's working perfectly. Now let's go to the mobile device. And you see, on the mobile device, it's looking great. The scroll effect is working perfectly with all of these images. Okay, so it's looking great on mobile device, tablet, and desktop. So from top right corner, click on this X to close the responsive bar. And when you are done, don't forget to click on this green update button to save your work. I hope you have learned something new today. If you like it, please give this video a big thumb up. And don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel. And press on the notification bell icon to get notified before anyone when I will upload a new video on this YouTube channel. Also, if you want me to help you on your WordPress project or Elementor project, then you can contact me through my website, that's jimfahaddigital.com. I will try my best to help you personally. Once again, thank you so much for watching this whole tutorial. I will see you in the next video. For now, bye-bye.